Sa mga kalaban nila sa Global Port, Gary David and Reed Huntilla ang nasa backcourt. Sly Morgan in the middle, and you have Yusuf Al-Jamal, Jason Deutschman on the flanks para sa mga batang Pierre at sa unang opensiba. Turnover na naging resulta para sa Alaska Aces, umaatake ngayon ang mga batang Pierre. Reed Huntilla nakakuha ng playing time past couple of games. Eric, this guy was a pickup. He wasn't in the lineup ng first conference natin, pero pagpasok nila rito sa second conference, they picked him up late, sparingly so far sa mga laro, but has occasionally shown some flashes of talent.
Well, you know, really going to be an asset, especially when he goes up against JV Castro.
Gabby Espinas umatake. Lumaban si Jason Deutschman, clash in the air.
Yabang, you know, he just works hard, walang toyo. So, you know, it's very nice to see with a you know, great attitude of an import. Pero ang hindi pa nakikita rin ng maraming tao, yung suporta ng locals. I mean, there's a lot of guys on the bench of Alaska, kagaya nga ng sinasabi kanina na yung mga naiba na injured a couple of days or one week. But there's a lot of guys stepping up. Even guys like Rafi Reyes, you know, helping out scoring-wise. There's so many players on that bench helping out. Even si Gabby Espinas also doing a great job on the post, helping out. So, ang daming sumusupporters, actually supporting cast. And that's the reason why this team has been very successful.
Alam mo, ganda na nabiling up mo yan, Eric. The fact that the locals are really helping out. It's not just this important ball game. Pero kung tingnan mo yung statistics on a per-game basis para sa Alaska Aces, you go through the box scores. Almost every game, there's someone new who steps up, whether it game to bring them to victory against a very strong Rainer Shine team. So, iba-iba ang nagsistep up. There's no constant. Even the one constant, yan nga si Robert Tozer.
Alam mo, maganda rin, Charlie, another point there is everybody's willing to do the dirty work. And in any successful team, even in wherever you see, the superstars, you know, gagawa at gagawain, but there will be some off nights. And then, makikita mo na lang yung mga coming off the bench may gumagawa, and then the superstars the one doing the dirty work. So that's one thing nice about a team like Alaska. That's why they're actually on top. It's because they have a lot of guys who are really willing to sacrifice for the victory of the team.
Casio stops and pops from the free throw line. Pasok yan para kay JV Casio. Of course, JV Casio has missed also a few games. Alam mo, another thing na nakakatuwa rin, kung ikaw ang isang Alaska fan, you'd be really happy dahil ang daming injuries din. They've been dealing with deadly injuries. Sonny Toss, kasi JV Casio was out for a while. And yet, they're able to sustain yung team playing nila. Kahit sinong isaksak mo sa lineup, can execute.
Yung isang game na nakita ko na wala si JV Casio was against Air 21. And you know, nahirapan talaga itong Alaska Aces when they played.
While we were away, itong si Yusuf Al-Jamal was able to get the miss. Itong si Jason Deutschman for the putback, tying up the ball game for a piece itong dalawang koponan. 9 minutes remaining sa ating first quarter. JV Casio on the curl, drops it to Dozier. Strong move.
Maganda to sa last play is itong JV Casio through the defense. Libring si Rob Dozier from the 15-foot line.
Si JV Casio kasi kahit ano sabi mo, on the run, whether he's out on the 3-point line, to the basket, he's a threat. Kaya nga yung mga dumedepensa, they sometimes collapse on him. May maganda ba baka, and he acknowledges that he passes it well.
Now, there are a lot of times that you know, JV would only not even score in double figures, but the beauty about it is he actually is a magnet on the defense. He actually, this, you know,
talk sa isang laro as far as scoring is concerned, that he was a scoring demon, especially in the college days niya. Has had a bunch of high-scoring games since coming into the Pro League last year, the number one pick 2 drafts ago. Pagpunta niya rin sa Alaska, nagang point guard position, so more of a distributor, but there are times na kahit pa paano, kumakamada pa rin.
Maganda rin kay JV, he actually can hit you, especially when it's crunch time. So maaasahan talaga siya Coach Luigi.
Si Sly Morgan, malayo sa basket, hands it off to Reed Huntilla. Morgan looks it out, 6 seconds sa kanilang shot clock. Global Port looking for a basket. Tado malakas offensive board para kay Sylvester Morgan. And he decides to take a three. Good decision on the part of Sly.
Well, Sly didn't really want to take it from 15 feet away. He's actually more confident shooting it from way out the 3-point range.
Labang ang Global Port ng isa. 7-25 in the first. Ito si Casio, just inside the 3-point line. Jumper goes para kay JV.
You know, when you make a mistake playing JV Casio in a 2-man game, if you go under, as I've said, he is actually very dangerous when 15 to 18 feet away.
They go down to Morgan. This is Morgan, pinasa kay Deutschman. Inilabas kay Huntida, takes a three. Bitin yun sa rebound, Dozier nakakuha. Tony De La Cruz, the veteran. Very patient ang opensa ng Alaska Aces. Casio takes a long jumper, doesn't go, pero tumahama pa kay Gary.
So, grabe talaga yung work ethic and yung attitude nitong import na to, because he even still tried to go for the defensive glass.
And here he is again, the quick path to Espinas. Jumper from 10. Pasok para kay Gabby Espinas.
Great teamwork there by the Aces, knowing that Booth is really open, especially from close range.
You know, Global Port partner, they're on a 9-game losing streak. And in this conference, they've won 2 games, 2 of their first 3.
Ang marami sa mga laro nila, close game eh. Tapos may scoring drought sila, 4 or 5 minutes, as you see.
Sly Morgan with a putback jam.
Pero sabi nga natin, they're in the ball game and they compete itong lineup na to.
Sabi nga natin, meron nga silang MMDA. Sinabi nga, yung apat na players na yun who were expected to, you know, to mesh and bring more wins para sa prangkisang ito. The problem is,
it hasn't translated into victories dahil hindi nga nagkakasabay-sabay yung magandang laro ng mga mamang ito. Well, you know, they're actually a new team. And in any new team, there'll be a lot of mistakes at team. And that's the value for JV Casio, having him healthy on your lineup.
For more on JV Casio, let's go back to Erica.
Ngayong andyan ulit si JV Casio, makikita ang difference kapag siya nagpapatakbo ng opensa ng team. But he affirms that it only seems like he's carrying the team because he is on the forefront of things bilang siya ang point guard. But he said it's all about
Erica. Nga, akuhin yung credit eh. Nasabihin niya, hindi. Gawa rin ng mga teammates ko yan. So that's why they click.
Well, there's a lot of humility in all the Alaska players right now. And ang maganda doon is actually translating into victories. Kagaya nga na nababanggit natin kanina, you have a guy like Coco Tiberos. He's a guy, a veteran, a superstar of the PBA. Nagagaling ngayon siya sa bench, but now he started for this game. Pero makikita mo eh, when he's needed, he produced the numbers. And then pag iba naman yung bawi, pero they actually always go to the guy who is actually most effective for the night.
Saktong sinabi mo na pag kailangan nila si Dodo ng Tiberos, he's effective. He hits a jumper from the 50-foot line para makuhuli ang kalamangan para sa kanyang tabunan. Under 5 minutes remaining sa ating first quarter, Deutschman. Deutschman, dinidikitan din experience yan. Dala natin, tumitira ng dress yan. Siguro Lingganay to Deutschman. Inside the lane, tries to lay it up. Supalpal mula sa likod. Deutschman has been more effective from the perimeter in his short career dito sa ating PBA.
His game is really from the outside. But you know, once you're in the PBA, you have to at least try to bring in that inside game because he says he's got good size. And, you know, he actually should know when it's really time to take it strong to the basket.
Sumubok na naman siya sa loob on that last play, pero nandinay na naman siya. Grabe rin ang pinawag ng Jason Deutschman. 4.5 remaining in the first. Ito si Gabby Espinas. Espinas takes the jumper. It's too strong. Nakakuha ni Deutschman ng rebound. Global port. Gusto sana tumakbo, pero ang bilis bumaba sa depensa ng mga Alaska Aces. Go to Morgan. Nakatira ng tres niyang kanina. Posting this time, the quick hook shot.
Well, he loves that post move and he's got a great jump hook. Mahirapan talaga si Rob Dozier yung tigilin, especially when he gets down deep.
Sam na puntos na para kay Sylvester Morgan. Pinitikita ni Aljamal si Donda, so he speed passes it over to Espinas. Tinawagan naman ng tsapahinga na muna siya ni Coach Junel Bakuli. Pinasok naman si Marquiat. Si Marky Eric, pinag-uusapan natin kanina before this game started. He's a guy you'd love to have on your team. This guy hustles. This guy's got some talent. He can score as well. And he can defend. Kahit import, kaya niyang depensahan.
You know, people would always say, especially yung mga nakakalaban or yung mga naiinis sa kanya, parang siyang peste.
Oh.
You know, he's always there defending. He always works hard. He's always a thorn on the side of the great superstars of the league because he's a great defensive player. And of course, he's actually an enforcer as well. But nababase yung mga kilosets, but he's actually producing the rebounds and the numbers as well.
Oh, pati yung mga hindi lumalabas sa stat sheet, yung mga loose ball recoveries, mga deflections. So Mark Yee, you know, I could say he's a bright spot in this SAR campaign para sa Global Port Batang Pier. So that's one of the things they can build on in the coming conferences. Deutschman tres mula sa Tabaraki. Bitin yan. Rebound Gabby Espinas ang humugot. Calvin Abueva is in the ball game para sa Alaska Aces. So you know naman, itong laro ng Alaska Aces, minsan umiba yung tempo. Tapos yun na nga, things just came apart somewhere along the way. You know, there were import changes. Tapos ito, finally he's out of the conference for the rest of this conference. Itong si Sol Mercado with an injury. So he'd have to sit out today. Papanoorin na lang yung team niya. Try to win this ball game. They have another game on Sunday. Para ako din naman ang kalaban.
Well, the positive side on Sol Mercado's campaign here in the Commissioner's Cup, you know, the beauty about it is he has really improved a lot, especially with his big court general. Yung mga assist na ginadagdag ni Sol Mercado for Global Court is actually very important because not only is a great offensive scoring machine, he can also put up, you know, involve his teammates on offense with a nice and timely assists.
Ano, ganda ng dalawang offensive rebound ng Global Port of that play. One by Marquez, second by Jason Deutschman. Hindi lang nila maipasok yung bola sa basket. And there was some intimidation on the part of Deutschman dahil sa depensa nitong si Rob Dozier. RJ Azuli, sa pang magandang laro sa backup point guard para kay Coach Luigi Trillo. Si Espinas, hindi na pinilit ngayon. And from the fact na may Dozier sila, Eric, meron silang Sanitos, meron pa silang Gabby Espinas, who I think are two of the best low post players in the league right now.
Maraming pinapahirapan si Gabby Espinas, especially on the low post. I've seen him actually destroy a lot of good defensive players on the post because he has great moves. Tapos he actually gets good position underneath. Kaya once he starts making his move, ang lapit na niya sa basket.
Sly Morgan. Wala ang kanyang perimeter jumper. Calvin Abueva ang nakakuha ng rebound. Siya na rin ang dala. Sumisenyas pa ng play. Si Calvin Abueva. Oh, point guard na ngayon si Calvin. They go to Hasul. Yung totoo point guard nila. Outside threat.
Yes. From three-point range. And he's actually very consistent. Especially when he's actually helping out his team. Lalong-lalo na. Kunyari, off yung isang kanyang teammate na inaasahan from the backcourt. Kayang-kayang gumawa ni RJ Hasul.
Ganda nga na nangyari kay RJ Azul. He was playing for the Air 21 team. And when he got traded dito sa Alaska, he was para kay Eric Salamat. So, alam naman niya, backup pa rin siya. Ganun ka si JB Casio.
And nangingibabaw in that last replay, scoring and hitting that free throw.
Alam mo ito si Japet Aguilar eh. Unang laro ng Global Port sa konferensyang ito was against the Petron Blaze Boosters. Opening game ng ating conference. Ronaldo Balcon at ito pa nun. And he was the best player of that ball game. And what a strong start para sa Global Court. They beat Petron on opening day. And things were looking really good para sa kanila. Stats were really great. Scored in the 20s. Got double figures yung rebounds. Pero sabi mo nga kanina, sa pregame natin, yung statistics na ba? The conference has gone on. It's flashes of brilliance like that from Japet na natutuwa yung mga tao. And, but at the same time, yun din yung kung saan naiinis yung ibang mga fans dahil minsan ang ganda talaga ng pinapakita ni Japet, you soar above everybody else, but on other nights quiet lang siya.
Well, at least Gagapano, Charlie, you know that this guy has so much potential. It's just a question of his preparation, mental preparation for the game. Eventually, you know, when the next season comes, he'll be more than prepared.
Tapos ang ating